One of the most exciting things happening right now is AI. It has the prospect of being very transformative. It has the prospect of increasing GDP, but at the same time, it has the prospects of increasing inequality, creating more unemployment, exacerbating the inequalities in our society and the polarization, which is already so large, and accelerating many of the harms that we recognize arose out of social media and the internet. Mis and disinformation, targeting people with the messages that polarize our society, undermining the, what's sometimes called the information ecosystem, leading to ethnic violence, as in Myanmar. While there's a lot of potential, there are an awful lot of downside risks. Confounding these problems is that it raises not only new challenges for antitrust law, competition law, but it also raises new questions about intellectual property. What has become very clear is that intermediaries like Google and Facebook have appropriated, used intellectual property from legacy media. Now it's very clear that the AI companies like OpenAI have appropriated a lot of the intellectual property of Google and the legacy media. And it appears that some of the newer AI companies have appropriated some of the intellectual property of the older AI companies. It's a mess. But it's a mess where some of the people, the greedy companies in the middle, the artificial intelligence companies, have taken, you might say, a very consistent stand. We have the right to take everybody else's property, intellectual property, but nobody has the right to take ours. What will you expect from American-style capitalism? It won't work. You have to compensate those who are producing the basic knowledge that goes into AI, and that means you have to give compensation to the legacy media, and that means you have to start enforcing the intellectual property laws, or rewriting them to reflect the contribution they are making, and you have to have competition laws that level the bargaining power of these and limit the bargaining power of the market power of these large behemoths. Europe has been leading the way in creating a regulatory framework that enhances the likelihood that these new developments will serve society rather than undermine society, but they don't go far enough. And the problem is that the United States, the power of these companies is so great that they've not only resisted regulation, they've resisted having any accountability in the way that ordinary media have accountability. They've gotten a kind of immunity. But they've now been under Trump and putting pressure on Europe to strip away its regulations. I hope Europe, Canada, and Australia won't give in to this power play, which is just a reflection of the greed on the part of a few large companies.